Aside from sex, dopamine plays a major role in motivating our brains to do all kinds of things. Even something that seems the opposite of sex, not furthering life, but risking it.
Yeah.
What is it about the pursuit of pleasure that would make these base jumpers in Moab, Utah, want to throw themselves off a cliff?
Pretty much all the cliffs out here have a pretty high danger scale. On a 1 to 10, they're all about an 8.
Mistakes can be fatal.
When you run off a 500-foot rock, you got about 6 seconds to live. And is that extreme? Yeah, you're darn right that's extreme.
Everybody ready?
And if this is the ultimate thrill for some people's brains, why not for everyone's?
This thrill is just basically essential for us to be happy, to have that feeling alive inside of you, so then life is worth it.
Science tells us that as a base jumper is thinking about the jump, their brain begins releasing dopamine. As with sex, dopamine plays the role of building anticipation. But unlike sex, the amygdala doesn't shut down. Instead, it's sending out fear signals.
Before a jump, I'll get the jitters and I'll get nervous and palms might get sweaty and a million thoughts racing in my mind.
Most of your mental preparation is, okay, what if my parachute opens backwards? What if I have a problem with one of my toggles?
Even though the jumpers are focused on the jump itself, you know, what they might not realize is that the dopamine kick is happening all along during this process.
You ready? Yes, I checked them.
Okay, no twist.
Cresta Christensen is a newcomer to base jumping.
I'm feeling excited. My heart's going a little bit faster because I know that that gear check means that it's getting a little bit closer.
3, 2, 1, see ya. Oh, I get so nervous.
It is unlike anything else that I've ever done, especially for someone that's scared of heights.
Cresta is nervous because her amygdala, where she harbors her fear of heights, is pressing the panic button at the sight of a 400-foot drop.
It's about as physiologically aroused as a person can be. You've got the stress system going, so you've got adrenaline being released that gets the heart going. You've got hormones being released. You've got stress hormones like cortisol going. You've got neurotransmitters like dopamine being released in anticipation of the euphoria.
But at the same time, Cresta's frontal lobes weigh in, making her question if she's doing the right thing. The fear, the pleasure, the potential risks, all these competing signals get processed into action, experts believe, in the striatum, in the middle of the brain.
And the striatum's kind of like a switching center. It's also the part of the brain that has the densest concentration of dopamine receptors.
As Cresta's dopamine rush bombards her striatum, her motivation for pleasure battles the other impulses. But will it be enough to make her jump? Inside the brain of a novice base jumper, there's a battle waging as she makes a life-threatening decision. Will Cresta risk everything for pleasure?
And just launch. Okay. Okay.
Clearly, the decision to jump means that the anticipated reward has won the battle between the good outcome and the potentially bad outcome. If it was the other way around, they would back away from the cliff and call it a day.
Oh, it was awesome. It was great. I'm ready to go up and do it again. Got to pack first, though.